4.5 years after the Brexit referendum, the UK has finally left the European Union's single market and customs union. What does that mean for New Zealand businesses? Well, if you're a British exporter, you're probably finding that you're dealing with a whole lot more paperwork and red tape than you had to before. But for New Zealand businesses, thanks to the hard work of the New Zealand government, it's pretty much business as usual. One thing that might affect New Zealand exporters, especially dealing with Northern Ireland, is that as some of these new rules bed in, they find that there are delays and complications at the border. What has changed, though, is that the UK is now looking for new trade deals, including with important trading partners like New Zealand. We've only had a few rounds of negotiations so far, but the atmospherics are very positive, and both sides have said that they're keen to conclude an ambitious agreement as soon as possible. That means that we could look to new opportunities in areas like services trade, whether you're a lawyer, an engineer, an architect, or a software designer, or in the digital economy. One area where things may not be quite such smooth sailing is in agriculture. New Zealand has made it very clear that to conclude a trade deal, the UK will have to come to the party on opening up its market for all agricultural products, including our wonderful meat, dairy, wine, horticulture and other products. We think that's entirely possible. We're counter-seasonal producers and uphold the same very high standards that the British do when it comes to things like food safety, quality, sustainability and animal welfare. But we must have that as part of an overall trade deal.
So follow us on Twitter, on Facebook, on LinkedIn, and at our website, tradeworks.org.nz.